Just arrived in my hotel room, the suite that I'm staying in tonight for the wedding, the night before the wedding. Some people are gonna come over for a few drinks later. Rolly will stay here with me tomorrow night. Maxie's here with me now, so I thought I'd give you a little tour. There's Max, crawling around. So we're in the Alice suite. So we've got just a cloak room to start with. It's quite big, it's got all of our stuff in. There's Maxie. There's the front door, and then so this is the main bathroom. It's quite nice, it's like all redone, I guess. Hi. Spa, toilet, shower, you know, fairly standard, but it's quite big. It's bigger than our main bathroom at home. King bed with a TV. It's really nice, nice views. I'll check out the beer. The gardens, we're getting married just over there somewhere. Think, yeah, where those palm trees are, and the river that's got in here. Yeah, so that's the view from this angle, and then there's another door. We have a whole lounge room. There's another TV, couch, a huge coffee table. It's like as big as our dining table. Yeah, proper six-seater dinner table. Are you okay? Hi, Max. He's not sure if he's laughing or crying. Hang on. There's a desk, and this has got two fridges in it, this little cabinet there. Another front door, mirror, and a separate little toilet in here just for, I guess, you know, privacy. There we go. Oh, I'm wearing my kitten. I've had that jumper for ages. It's pretty boring. Yeah, so that's that. Oh, look out there at that beautiful pink flowers on that tree. Yeah, so it's huge, really. Can't believe it. I'm going to take Max down the road now and go and grab some juices and some fruit and stuff for the room, some snacks or whatever for later. Good morning. It's the day of our wedding. I'm so excited. I think it's 10 to 6. And I'm guessing Max is probably awake. We have splashed out. We have our regular babysitter looking after Max for the night, for last night and tonight, overnight, just because he doesn't sleep well. On and off, it's always a bit risky. And I knew that I wouldn't be able to sleep last night anyway. So I thought, well, it'd be good to have somebody else just make sure he's okay. Anyway, so I didn't get to sleep until about midnight. I was just laying here for about two and a half hours. I think I went to bed at about 9:45. Just laying and thinking, will I make a speech? What will I do? I wasn't really stressed about anything though, and I want to tell you why, because another little luxury that we've splashed out on, which actually turned out to be not really a luxury at all. Well, when I say luxury as in like expensive, is we hired a wedding planner. And I can tell you 100% that if we didn't have a wedding planner, I would not be looking this less stressed. She has been amazing, especially in the last few weeks. She's a couple of thousand dollars, I can't exactly remember how much. She's a friend of a friend, and she is the one bearing all the stress at the moment. She would be nearly due to arrive at the venue, because like the place where we're having it, ceremony's at 11:30, and I think we only get access to the area at like 8. So she's got only like 3 hours to set up the whole restaurant, the whole area for the ceremony, all the decorations. She's got to coordinate the delivery of all the furniture, all the flowers, be the point of contact for the pastor and the photographer and everything like that. So she's taking on all of that responsibility. So all I've been doing, and all Rolly's been doing for the last week and a half, is just like hanging out with various friends and family that have come to town. And it's amazing. Like, we have been a little bit stressed because there are things that we chose the package where we did a few things. Like, and obviously we had to pick like the table plan, and we had to do, like actually, I can't can't even think of what we've had to do. That's how chilled out I am about it. It's really cool. So I highly recommend it, because not only is she doing all of the things that you would normally be running around freaking out about, like where's the flowers, are they late, they've gone to the wrong venue, this person has done that, that, the other, you know, all of that stuff, where's the cake, the cake's not here, whatever. But the other thing is that we were like, what, where do we have it, who do we use, like what photographer do we pick? And when you Google Brisbane wedding photographer, like 100 million hits. Like, it's ridiculous. So we just decided, our friend who's doing our wedding planning for us, she gave us a list of three or four. We had a meeting, we went through all the things we wanted for our wedding to be, and she sent us a list of three venues that she thought we should go and check out. So we went, and the first one we went to, which was the first one she recommended, was like perfect. Then she had a list of three photographers, and we went and met with those, and the first one she said that would be perfect for us is the one we went with. Same as the pasta, same as like the cake people. They were like, it was just incredible the amount of time we saved researching and looking for the right vendors for people to use, and also in our price range, our style. It was all like so much easier for the amount of stress that it saved, for the amount of time that it saved, and actually for the amount of money that she saved. But also as well, like the theme and the styling that we wanted to go with, like picking this vendor and that vendor, and then maybe them not going matching all together. Like, I'm not a very good designer in that sense, so I feel that it was so well worth the money for all of those reasons. So if you can, if you're planning an event and you can find a spare few $1,000, I think it actually will end up being actually quite a lot less overall. So I highly recommend you look into that. Yeah. So anyway, I thought I would share that just before the madness starts. I think I'm going to have a quick shower and then go and get Maxi and get ready for the day. The photographers arrive. No, not the photographer. The makeup people arrive, or lady, comes at 7:30, I think. So I would like to be ready for that. I maybe even go downstairs and have some breakfast. I'm rambling. I'm so excited. I can't stop thinking about all the things. Ugh. Okay. This is the face of a person who's getting married today.
Hi, Max. Are you having some yummy banana for brekkie?
Before.
I'm filming, by the way. That's my mom.
Hi.
It's a beautiful day. Yes. Such a nice view. So this is overlooking back towards our house, the Botanic Gardens. The city is behind us. I think Kate's room has a city view. There's the river. Yeah, so the river goes all the way around and around there and curves back around where the trees are, like that. Hi, Max. What are you in?
Look at Mummy. Say hi, Mum.
Hey, guys.
Hi, Mum.
Hey, guys. What does it say? Hey, Dad. Here comes Mum. How cool. It's so cute.
And then the bath is just...
funny.
I couldn't have it plain at the back.
Nice. It was yummy. Max is having blueberries. Are they yummy? So cute. Carol's getting her hair and makeup done, or hair done.
Do you
want any bits out around your face, or just like
this little buttonhole for Dad and Max? That's my
sea holly. That's what it's called. I kept thinking about it whole time.
Silas. Just a quick last film. We're ready.
Yay.
Hey, this is the after. This is the aftermath of us getting ready and having everybody here and everything. Here we go.
So you've got to be in it too. Is this your wine
show or something else? Mine's all gone.
Finished hers. Oh, do you want a top up?
It's gone.
It's gone.
It's gone.
Okay. So, yeah, we're all ready and now we're just waiting till we're fashionably late.
How you feeling, Roland?
Feeling good.
Excited.
It'd be better if we were in the shade and not standing in the sun.
Oh, don't worry. Good. It'll be.
Is Max your boy here?
He is, he looks very cute. Hi, Maxie.
Hi.
So cute.
Hey, one back to the chair.
He gives this woman to be married to this man. Thank you, Chad. Ladies and gentlemen, you can be seated. Gather around, find a comfortable spot.
Yeah, move over one.
Awesome. Well, Rachelle was all set to say yes. She was all set to say yes up on a glacier. Then she was all set to say yes up in the beautiful Burj Al Arab. Then she was all set to say yes in Munich in front of a beautiful church. Then she was all set to say yes when they arrived in Barcelona. And then at the very last opportunity before they boarded a cruise ship, when Rachelle hadn't even brushed her teeth, rolling, nervous as anything, bust into the room, he was half on one knee before he made it in, and popped the question. And finally, after four countries, and many close attempts, Rachelle was able to say yes, and they were finally, finally engaged. And what an incredible couple we're here to celebrate with. And their union today brings together two separate, wonderful families and all of their traditions, but just before we get underway with the wedding ceremony, Rolly and Rachelle really wanted to take a moment to honour their parents, to thank them for teaching them about family, for teaching them the skills required to have a happy marriage, for loving and supporting them throughout their lives and also today as they become husband and wife. So thank you. And well done. They made it. Good job. We're going to start with a reading that Rolly and Rachelle have chosen. It's called Of Shared Love in Marriage by Victor Hugo. You can give without loving, but you can never love without giving.
The great acts of love are done by those who are habitually performing small acts of kindness. We pardon to the extent that we love. Love is knowing that even when you're all alone, you'll never be lonely again. And great happiness of life is the conviction that we are loved. Loved for ourselves, and even loved in spite of ourselves. That's a great picture of marriage. Well, that's a beautiful reading and a wonderful introduction to this celebration of friendship, celebration of love, and a celebration of commitment. The marriage of Roland and Rachelle. There's an old Irish saying about marriage. It goes like this. From this day forward, you shall not walk alone. My heart will be your shelter, and my arms will be your home. And today, Roland and Rachelle are building that home. And with the vows that they'll soon make, they're committing to walking that path together. And it is with much pleasure that I now, in the sight of God and the presence of these witnesses that you've gathered, pronounce you husband and wife. Roland, you may kiss your wife. Congratulations, guys. Isn't that awesome? Yeah, one more time, let's put our hands together for Roland and Rachelle. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're just going to step aside for a few moments and sign all the official paperwork. You feel free to chat amongst yourselves, and we'll be back with you really, really shortly. Thank you so much.
Hey, Rachelle, do you want me to keep going?
Nathan, you right to probably move the table over there onto the path in the shade. That'd be awesome. That way the photos will be back there and they'll be in the shade.
Come on over, Rachelle.
It's a plane! Pretty much every time a plane comes over.
Everyone wave. She's got you on video. From video. Did you enjoy walking down the aisle? You did a good job.
Jack?
It was great. She looks gorgeous.
It's over.
Yeah. Have moved away from this area. Can I get you back, just so that when Rachelle and Roland are leaving, there's some people sort of celebrating with them, rather than, yeah, we were on our own. So if you can fill up these chairs again, just so when they're walking out, we can celebrate, that'd be awesome. And then Roland and Rachelle are going to make their way out, and they're going to sort of turn right and go onto that paved area, because that's obviously a great spot for some group photos. So gather around and just make sure there's a bit of an aisle that'll bear right
That'd be fantastic.
This is Roland and Rachelle Glendon. This guy as much as I do, he'll be your mate for life. Thank you.
she and Roland together have produced Max and done an amazing job of raising him. We got some hints as to how well they might accomplish that when they took on a dog, which I had grave misgivings about, I have to say. But I was really amazed at how well they did.
Looked after a dog.
And they continued to work that partnership that they've got between them to do and achieve what they've achieved today. And I'm sure they're going to continue to do so in the future. So, wonderful congratulations to you. And I'm very, very happy to be part of your family.
I guess to add to that, we should ask for Roland's mum to come up and say. She's going the long way.
Where's Daddy?
Sue Stubbs, my stepmom, Roland's mum.
Well, as you can imagine, I'm a very proud mama today.
Yeah.
You know, from the moment Rolly introduced Clyde and me to Rachelle, we knew she was a keeper. That was nearly 6 years ago, and now they're officially husband and wife.
Yeah.
I'll always give you both my love and support, and just wish you oceans of happiness in the future.
Yeah.
That's awesome. Thanks, sir. That was lovely. A big round of applause for Clyde.
Yay! Hey, woo!
Thanks, man. I'll keep this short. So, when Ron and I were kids, I used to stuff them into the bottom of a sleeping bag and push them down the stairs. Among other torturous activities, Mum said that today would be an ideal opportunity to make a public apology for all that stuff. But you know what? I actually feel kind of partly responsible for making him the resilient man that he is today. And you know, I was absolutely honoured when he asked me to be the best man. Well, you didn't actually ask me to be the best man. In Roland's words, he just said, "Man, can you stand up there with me for a little bit so I don't look like a dick?" Mate, I look on them all, mate, as you build your business successfully, while still finding time to play plenty of golf, watch endless reruns of Top Gear. Mate, you're passionate, you're hardworking, yes, you love a whinge. But ultimately, mate, you get the job done and you enjoy life along the way, which is the most important thing. Mate, we're absolutely stoked to see you and Michelle start a family with the awesome Maxi. And I'm looking forward to watching him and Harry grow up together as kids, just like we did, mate. Hopefully without some sleeping bag incidents. So, ladies and gentlemen, if you could, Ron and Michelle, I love you both very much. If you could all raise your glasses for a toast.
Yeah!
To Roland and Rachelle. Thanks, all. That was awesome. I guess we should probably hear from the happy couple as well. That's teamwork right there, isn't it? You can hold it while I read it.
I think it's talking about the speech.
So first of all, I'd like to thank you all for being here and sharing mine and Rachelle's special day. Many of you have travelled interstate, and Holly, Lou, and the kids' case overseas. each and every one of you have had a significant role in my marriage. And it's all been positive. When we booked this venue, we thought 80 people would be plenty. When it turned out, we could have had so many more. We are both so grateful for all the loving and special people we have in our lives, and the fact that you're all here today, we thank you. To Jack and Carol, thank you for being there for Rachelle. She had it tougher than most growing up, and I thank you both for making her the woman that she is today. Well, I'm very happy to hear from you. I'm so happy that you have both accepted me into your family so graciously. Dad, awesome speech. I wouldn't have expected anything less, though. I also can't thank you enough for bringing us to Australia 20 years ago now, from the UK. Without you, I wouldn't have ever got to meet Rachelle. And for that, I'll be forever grateful.
Yeah.
I'd like to thank Mimi for her ongoing love and support. It makes me very happy knowing that you're there today. Mum, the epitome of a beautiful person. You're a wonderful client. Mum is definitely, she's pretty much the most loving person I know. I'll never forget the things you did and sacrificed for me and Ollie, and we are both truly grateful. I'm so glad that you ended up so happy too. It was inevitable though, really, because you know what they say, good things happen to good people. Floyd has been quite the role model for me since him and Mum have been together. Both in helping you starting up high tech and life in general. This is true, thanks so much, Floyd. You may be stubborn at times, but at least you can back it up with all your money. Another role model has been my brother Ollie.
Legend.
Ollie was, like you said before, a bit of a prick when we were little. But without his discipline, I couldn't imagine how much more of a rat bag I would have been. Thank you for being that big brother I needed, and I can't wait for you back in Australia so we can watch our kids grow up together. All of Rachelle's friends, kind of get it, nice, same table over there, actually. Yeah, everywhere. I'm glad I've got to meet most of you now. Rachelle always mentions how blessed she is to have each and every one of you in her life, so thanks for being so awesome. To all the boys, I'd like to thank you for all the fun times we have had, and for that there has been plenty. So many awesome days and nights, but I actually get a bit tired now, thinking how we got through it all in one piece. I know that there will be many more fun times to have, maybe not as loose, but just as fun. I want to have a special shout out to your mate Clint, sitting down here.
Oh, thanks.
Some of you may not know, but when we came to Australia back in October 1996, the teacher sat me next to Clint. A little to his pissed offness, right. At least you had to call me dude there. And it's crazy to think that 20 years later, on my wedding day, you're still sitting here. Thanks, mate.
Yeah, always, bro.
Mention the golfing guys. I think they're all
right
next to each other. Definitely not there on the fairway, that's for sure. Still plays that way,
Frank.
I've always been a competitive sportsman until recently. I play golf just because I love it. Not to win, but to have fun. I thank you guys for being down there at Windaroo, as I don't reckon I'll play if you guys didn't do. Okay. I'm with a special aid. I've been on camera my 30th. I don't know if you realise it, but I forgot to mention Rachelle at all. Okay, so as most of you are aware, I'm not very religious or spiritual. But when it comes to Rachelle, I believe in the soul. Mainly due to the fact that hers is so beautiful. I love the fact that she is so loving and genuine. You know what you get when it comes to Rachelle. I love that she keeps me grounded when I get agitated and picks me up when I'm feeling down. I feel that I've been truly blessed to have met her, traveled with her, had a beautiful baby boy with her, and be privileged to be able to spend the rest of my life with her.
Aww.
Most of you know that we have a dog called Honey. and we both love her with all our heart.
No.
Even though most of the time I feed her, water. I'm pretty much the favorite donor though. But I still know she loves Cheryl more.
She does.
I'll be sitting there on the couch, honey, come here, and she'll be straight to Rachel. I think it's because that dogs have a sixth sense for a beautiful soul that Rachel has.
No.
I love you, baby, so much. And I thank you for now being my wife. And I promise to be all I can for you forever and ever. There are not enough words to describe how much I love you. And if there are, I don't think I have the vocabulary for it. So, I think we can just raise one more toast.
Woo! To Rachelle! Beautiful love happened.
Well, they've obviously planned, like, as I know Rachel wanted to come back into this as well.
Oh.
It's so thick as well, though.
Like, there's heaps.
Oh, thank you.
We've had an amazing day, haven't we? It's the end, it's like beautiful. 9 o'clock, and we're ready for bed. It's been a long day, hasn't it?
It's been lovely.
Love you guys.
Thank you.